Welcome to Crimson Guitars, welcome to the 2020 build. This is a final super edit of the entire build in one shot. If you want to see a blow-by-blow, go back and watch the earlier videos. But I made this guitar. The challenge was to build it in 20 hours, 20 minutes. It was designed by you guys. I went somewhat crazy. The beautiful thing is, one of you has won it. And at the end of this video, we'll find out who. I have a random number generator. I have a list of entries. It's going to be cool. Unlike whatever I just did there. Burn it. Yay! The plan was I was going to do it contiguously, i.e. we were all going to stay up for about 24 hours and just build a guitar. But, health and safety kind of put pay to that. I'm not allowed to have staff work for that long. I'm not allowed to work for that long with machinery, apparently. Losing fingers and things like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually spread this out over 3 days. We've got a timer and pretty much that's it. We went on our Instagram and we put a load of questions up. Do you want a multi-scale or a standard scale or Fender, Gibson, etc., etc., etc.? Of course you guys went for multi-scale. Multi-scale won by 563 votes to 200 or 300 for each of the other ones. Guitar, bass, or baritone. Guitar won with 430 votes to, I can't read my writing, 350 and 305. We gave the option for a custom inlay. That had 805 votes out of over 1,000. Six string won by a couple of hundred votes. Semi-hollow, of course, won by like 70%, 748 votes to 482. Twin humbucker, because, you know, you had to do one boring thing. And of course, through neck, 802 votes out of 1,354. We then went and said, fine, whatever. Please give us your suggestions for a design, a body sort of shape. And also please give me ideas for inlays. Now that was a little bit more fun. We had a dead heat between people who suggested Explorer and people who suggested a Flying V. A lot of people suggested that I take something to do with my head tattoos and turn it into an inlay. And then a lot of other people suggested planets, which I'm gonna have to do at some point. The winning guitar was a through neck, multi-scale, semi-hollow, Explorer with head tattoo inlays. That's what I'm building. And I went downstairs and found some Badook. That actually is that heavy. But it's gonna be semi-hollow. Should we start building?
Coffee.
This was gonna be a little bit more fun if it was all done in one hit, but this is the 2020 challenge coffee count. There's already some in there, and I'm going to do a tally chart on how much I drink.
Oh, that was cold. Ow, ow.
Ah, start.
Ah. We're 1 second in.
Okay, so we are going to be building a through neck instrument. We're lucky at Crimson Guitars. A number of years ago, actually, I spent a lot of time drawing plans. And we actually sell these as part of our Luthiers supplies sort of thing. And when you voted Explorer, I thought, wow, I've got the plans for that. So here we go. What I am going to be doing that is different is many, 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 many things. I don't particularly like the Explorer headstock. It just doesn't do it for me. I'm gonna go for a reverse headstock because I like the physics behind it. And obviously it's fanned fret. Now, of course, because it's fanned fret, the options with pickups were either we have standard pickups that are just put with the angle, or we custom make some angled pickups. So I need to do this design drawing, and once that is done, I need to send it down to my fantastic team downstairs who are going to make a custom pickup. When you are designing a guitar, specifically a fan fret guitar, you have one fret that is square, i.e. horizontal and perfectly wonderful.
12th.
Okay, so that is where we're going to start. Once you've got your horizontal fret, that's all that really matters. So we want to go from Fender up at the bass, Ibsen at the treble. Okay, 12th fret, so 24.75, and obviously that's our nut. That's our 22nd fret there. And then we want to go for 25.5 scale. You put that on the 12th fret there. The nut will be there. 22nd fret there. Then essentially, that's where my nut is. That's where my 22nd fret is. Nice, gentle fan fret. Now, I could have done something a little bit more extreme if I had really wanted to, but one of the really important things about this build is that we're giving it away. I wanted to make it something that somebody who'd never even considered fan frets would want to own. So it's a fairly gentle fan. Let's start with the center line. The crimson rulers come with a zero in the middle, so you can sort of quickly and easily work out where you're at. Without your center line, nothing works. Do you know what? I'm actually kind of nervous about this build. I haven't done a build challenge in a long time. If you haven't watched them, go back on our channel. Pretty much the very first series that we did was a 24-hour challenge. Yeah, where I built a guitar in 24 hours. Over a several month period, really. Because of finishing and all that. And then I went and did a 12, which is still one of my favorite personal guitars, a 9 and a 6, one of which I actually managed to, well, watch the series. I've got my center line, I've got my 12th fret. From those 2 points, everything gets worked out. That is absolutely right. 12th nut. Working from the 12th fret, which is parallel, I mark out the longer 25 and a half inch scale. Okay, remember, so we're going with a crimson headstock, reversed. I'm marking it out, that's the nut line on the template. My center line is there. Which would be quicker, using hand planes or some sort of a template system? Probably hand planes, actually. Next up is truss rod. Because I don't want to build a guitar that is potentially not, or not as good as it possibly can be, even in a 20-hour challenge, that's 20 minutes, I'm going to put carbon fiber stiffening rods down the length of this as well. Lancashire pattern hacksaw. I just love them so much.
Let the guitar building begin.
Well, I'm going to spot glue in these. First thing to do really is just check we've got the length correct. The last thing I want to do is sand these down. Carbon fiber is not fun stuff to breathe. There we go. The goggles were to avoid the possibility of super glue in my eyeballs. That is not a fun thing to have happen. Please. Please believe me. Two coffees. Are we ready? Are you ready? You ready? 5 seconds. And that is the whole point of this entire thing. It's another custom door wedge. Now, because we've got a fan fret and we've got the nut at an angle, I'm going to be planing the headstock down at a slight angle, actually. Normally, I would have locating pins located in the fret slots, because normally we will have a fretboard that we've pre-slotted using a jig. I'm going to be cutting these fret slots by hand. So we have some padauk. An Explorer is a somewhat huge instrument. I'm going to glue the neck onto a back piece, like that. At the same time, I'm gonna construct parts of tops and all of that. Well, the only way to do it is to do it, isn't it? Really. One done, one to go. Ha, I knew it, bloody knew it. Let's not play around like that. You guys said custom inlay, an inlay based on my head tattoos, which is fine. You get to look at them a lot. I don't really. So apparently this new phone doesn't make noises when you, is that really what I look like? Now the nice thing about the tattoo,
from my point of view, is that it's fairly sketchy in the first place.
Yes. Having a head tattoo is fairly sketchy as well.
That's complex. We don't want complex at all. We want something that I can do within a few lines that would give the idea of what I have on my head.
Okay, the other option is I cheat.
I'm phoning my media department.
Sister, you're on camera, although not on speakerphone. Do you have a copy of the sort of the triple moon thing on the front of my head on your computer, per se? Could you print off a bunch for me at like 40 mil?
Cheers, I'll see you in a second.
Yeah, I'm gonna make it as one whole piece and then etch where the crossovers are.
There we go. Yeah, okay, I like that.
When you're drilling metal, always, 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 just always, always, always wear protection. And also don't drill into your nice inlay jig.
What do you think?
What do I do about the edge of the guitar? Now I've got these chunks of wood looking rather lovely, and the thought really was have these as the sides, but not continuously around the edge. We have a supporting structure here. We have a sound hole all there, and we have a supporting structure up to here, potentially. Sound hole here, or sound port, or whatever you want to call it. And what I'm doing is I'm avoiding a load of routing and messing about with routers and doing cavities and all that, creating something a little bit more interesting. Not quite. Okay, that's spot on 12. And that is pretty bloody close too. All right, that's spot on 12 too. Because we have a multi-scale length, the scale length is actually set at the position of the strings, which is fine and well and good. But I have removed some material, haven't I? To make things a little bit easier, I'm gonna go with a scalpel across every single one of these frets that I've just marked out again. That gives the saw something to bite into. Where do we want you? Oh, that's okay, isn't it? This is a piece of bog oak that, so it's 3,000 years old. It came from a gentleman who gave me a chunk to build a guitar out of, and I'm building a guitar out of it. This is one of the pieces from there. And I'm gonna do my binding out of it. With a through neck build, you have to get most of the work done, or all of the work done on the neck, before it starts looking like a guitar. That looks pretty cool, doesn't it? I am biased.
Prepare the frets.
Now, because we've got binding, I've got this task ahead of me, and that is just nipping some of the tang off so that it fits in the slot. Okay.
All right, Paduke dust.
It's okay, as long as there isn't a splinter in there.
There is no reason, nor excuse, except for that I was left unsupervised. Let's go to the bandsaw then. The big bandsaw, downstairs. Okay, so we are convinced this is in the right place. Let's go downstairs and do some sanding. Woohoo! Everywhere we go, there's Padauk dust. I suspect it's my fault. I'm thinking a really big inlay. Not sure why I'm thinking that, but you know, that might actually work. It's pretty cool. Let's get that glued on as soon as humanly possible. Then we can play around with tops and sides and bits and pieces. Oh, no, that could be fun. I've got it. Second top. And I can cut that all 5mm thing. It's a little bit bigger. One guitar. Ish. We haven't completely messed that up. And we can see what's happening. Are you not impressed?
Is this not impressive?
I've got to do frets, hardware, pickups. I've got to figure out what I'm doing, wiring-wise. There we go. Now, because this is going to end up being more brown than red, I've gone for one of the white acrylic logos that we use on the production guitars. The time has come. I've decided to give it away to myself. Sorry, y'all. The time has come, the build is done, apart from the case, which will be coming at some point soon when we can finally get the stuff we need to do it. I have here a list of 10,196 orders. Not orders, entries into the competition. If you will recall, buying anything on the website entered you into the competition, and any £10 within that order was an entry. So we have a gentleman who has 143 entries here. We don't want to have addresses and things, but anyway, yep, there we go. So basically, a load of entries. Ooh, pretty, pretty. And every color is a different band within that order. I have a random number generator. There's an app for everything. So we've got a minimum of, oh, hold on, minimum of one.
Two.
Exclude these numbers. We need to exclude the number one. Hold on. Edit. Okay. Save. So I've excluded the number one because number one is the title, the big thing. And then the maximum is 101. 10,196. Look at that. I can do it. And we're generating numbers. And they're random. 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 I am going to push this. And somebody's going to win, and then I'm going to scroll through this. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Are you?
I mean, we could do this, like, we can wait till the case comes along and we... I have the random number generator. I'm just randomly generating numbers. These are not order numbers, so that's fine. Okay, 4640. That sounds like a good number. Hi, how's it going?
Going off.
Oh, go that way. Honestly, looking at these colors flip past is introducing a latent 4640, wasn't it? It feels like I'm going to develop epilepsy or something. Oh, actually, we're nearly there. Look at that, I nearly stopped correctly. So, we are looking. At. I've got a name here. I don't really want to send a guitar to Canada. A lot of people bought things like guitar building courses or full guitars that entered you into the competition with, you know, 100 or more actual entries into it. This gentleman has 5 entries, and I'm going to try and phone him in a second and see if we've got permission to do that. We are going to ask permission at the end of this if we're allowed to actually film this or not. So, yeah.
You have reached mailbox number 6132.
No.
6939. Please leave your message after the tone.
It's a mailbox, not a phone. It's just a number to leave a message at. Should I leave a message anyway? Hi Arthur, this is Ben Crowe calling from Crimson Guitars in the UK. I need to talk to you about something. Would you be able to give us a call back on... What is our phone number? 01300-348-863. And you, so what's 43?
No idea.
So now we wait for him to phone and it's not going to be on camera. So I think that's the end of the video, people. It's been emotional. I'm going to go play with matches. Goodbye. Arthur.
Yes.
How are you?
I must say it's very, very good. It's very strange to hear your voice coming from my phone rather than my computer.
We should do it more often. This isn't technically about your order. Basically,
okay.
The 2020 build, you won it.
Oh, really? That's awesome.
So...
Cool beans.
There we go. This man knows. I must say that it's a very, very good thing that you actually know what I'm talking about. The last guitar that somebody won, he didn't have a clue.
No, I watched the whole series. It was great. Look forward to it every Friday.
Fantastic. Okay. Well, this makes me happy. Are you a player or are you a builder or what's...
Oh, yeah. I'm a player. player, and at some point, I actually have some friends that live not far from Dorchester, so we're actually hoping to go and take a two-week course there at some point. So, like, we're in Canada, obviously. So
yeah, absolutely.
It'd be a bit of a trek, but hopefully at some time I will build my own guitar, but I own, like, a stupid number of them that my wife keeps saying, you know, why do you have so many guitars?
Well,
there's always room for one more.
Well, this is the thing. Now you need to tell us, sweetheart, honestly, this one wasn't my fault. But no, it's excellent. I'm really, really, really glad. It's one of those things. I enjoy giving things away, but it's always nice to know that it was somebody who actually did watch the series and knew what we were talking about. I am going to be building an incredibly cool case for this. It's probably going to be. Do you know what? I can't even guess at this point. We're still waiting.
I assume you're going to be videoing that.
Yes. Yeah. I'll video that for sure.
Cool, because I'm going to own an instrument now where I actually have videos that show it being built. That's like, how unique is that?
It doesn't happen often. What did you think I was calling about?
I have no idea. There was an outside chance that my wife, because I have a birthday coming up, was booked me in for a course or something like that. That's what maybe I was thinking, or maybe she can coerce you to give me a happy birthday or something, because she knows I watch the videos all the time. I had no real idea. You know, I thought there was an outside chance it could have been this, but I thought that had already been done. Like, you know, in my mind, that had been given away already. So
first of all, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Tell your wife, yeah, if she's going to buy you a course for the birthday, which I strongly suggest is a really good idea.
Yeah, right now it's kind of hard to know when we could do that, right? That's the only problem.
Yeah. But anyway, look, it's been, it really has been excellent talking to you.
Thank you very much, sir.
It's an absolute pleasure. Have a fantastic day and...
Stay safe.
Excellent, you too. I'll speak to you soon. Cheers. There we go. It's gone to somebody who will play the guitar, who watched the whole build, who knew what was happening. And I now feel guilty that it wasn't a phone call from me to say happy birthday. Oh, no. That's going to have to be something that I offer to people now, every now and then. Look, this has been incredible. Oh, here we go. I'm holding his guitar. Yeah, I enjoyed that. Please subscribe. It makes me happy and gives me validation, etc. I'll see you soon. Goodbye.